Second, traffic behind the CRJ.
Wilson traffic.
Copy.
We're going 202, landing time 19, I'm going to get right deck on Golf. Go, go. 202. Kenya 760 clear for takeoff, runway 06, sensors in disregard.
Takeoff 06, Kenya 760.
Stopwatch, elapsed time checks.
To continue on call, the control 1-1
spooling.
1-1, please.
Thank you.
Skip.
And on Togger.
And on Togger checks. Reduce takeoff 07, both engines.
D1.
Positive, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have a lovely view of Mount Kilimanjaro, which sits at 19,340 feet. As you can see right now, aircraft is using GPS left. We have two GPSs on this aircraft, unlike the some of the 300s with no GPS would be using our IRSs for updating, being updated by either VORs, DAVs. Okay, so to the right of the EHSI we have the ISFD, which has a backup battery power which is self-contained of 150 minutes, and we also have the selection of approach, which means that in case everything else fails, we still get our ILS displayed on the screen. And the good thing with this instrument is that regardless of whether you pull the CB in flight, you can't turn it off. Right now, we're getting the low pressure lights on the center tank. That means we've exhausted our pumps. So I'd advise, I'd ask the pilot monitoring to have the pumps off, which is done. And we check recall just to check that what's been done, has what's the actions that have been taken are exactly what.
We're about 2 hours and 10 minutes into our flight, and in a few minutes we'll be starting our descent for Bangui. However, we've just been advised that there'll be a VIP departure, and we expect to hold just to the south of the airport for a few minutes before we can commence our approach. We'll be landing on runway 35, which is about 2,600 meters. Relatively short for the 737-800.
Roger, continue approach, report 4 miles on final. Caution bird around the runway.
Continue approach, call again 4 miles final. Copy, caution, in the 5-7.
Landing gear. Down 3 greens.
Flaps.
13 green light.
Clear crosswind.
Right 5-2-3, Mangita, confirm leveling 050.
In Kenya 5-7-6, 4 miles final, island 35.
Clear to land, runway 35, the wind 170 degrees, 02 knots.
Left line, runway 35, Kenya 576.
Okay, manual flying.
Flight direction.
Checked.
Approaching minimums.
Checked.
Approaching minimums. 300. Minimums. 100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
I copy to my 80 knots checked.
Onion braking.
November Lima Yankee, we'll continue down to Delta Echo and track 299 16 miles to Disto, which is our initial approach fix, and we'll transition to the ILS 30 via Disto. Chart is 11-1, dated 3rd December 2010. Localizer Delta Lima 110.3, set on standby on both. Final approach course of 299 set on both. Glide slope 5 miles from Delta Lima.
MC speeds.
Speed.
Okay. Flap 5.
Yes, flap 5.
Flap 5. On the glide.
On the glide, checked.
Warlock and glide slope armed.
Warlock, glide slope armed, check.
CP speed, warlock and glide slope.
Join you in ILS.
Kenya 576, digital established on the ILS.
Roger, Cockpit, report 4 miles on final.
I will call Kenya 576.
Gear down. Flaps 15.
Here is the gear down. Flaps 15.
Flares armed.
Checked, flares armed. LNAV armed also.
LNAV armed,
checked. 1,000 feet, 1014.
Check.
Check.
1,000.
And the runway inside.
Checked. Called all the way to minimums.
Interview hand on shot fana.
Roger. Rain inside.
Five hundred.
Checked. 200 to minimums.
Check.
400. approaching minimums.
That was the approach into Douala. It was a bit rainy with a lot of clouds all the way through to minimums, but at least by few hundred meters to minimums, we were able to see the runway, and we took it down and brought it down well. But actually, it get worse, and Douala had some really bad weather. It's a really rainy and tropical. Can you call it tropical? What is it? Equatorial weather with a lot of sunshine, heat, and a lot of rain. Yeah, rainy sea actually.